Amazon is the third biggest company in the world, with an evaluation of $1.5 trillion. And whilst most people imagine it as an e-commerce platform, in reality, the majority of Amazon's revenue comes from AWS Cloud Computing. AWS provides servers for software developers and companies to host their applications around the world. Whilst AWS has many benefits, especially compared to other options, such as buying and hosting your own server, there are still drawbacks. AWS is notoriously quite complicated. It has over 200 products and services available with made-up fancy names like EC2 and Elastic Beanstalk, just to make your life a bit harder. Each of these products has further configuration and requirements that need to be studied and implemented to make the application work and not accidentally get into thousands of dollars of debt. To navigate this sea of complicated terminology and configurations, AWS has certifications that they offer. All this means if you hire someone who is capable of using AWS, they won't necessarily be able to navigate anywhere near as well with other cloud service providers, leaving companies and developers often stuck with their initial cloud provider. But isn't that fine? Why would you want to move cloud providers anyway? Well, what also happens with cloud providers is they can set prices for the services as they wish. So whilst it may be cheaper to use AWS today, when your company scales, it may become more expensive. And by that time, you won't have a choice whether or not to stay. There are currently many workarounds to this issue, but the workarounds are still just that, workarounds. They do not provide an easy and optimal solution, and are often hard to do. I know what you're thinking. Did you not click on a video about decentralized computing? Yes, this is exactly the solution to current cloud providers that many people propose. Decentralized computing would essentially create infrastructure necessary for a marketplace of computing without a company like Amazon being in control. This marketplace would make computing a commodity, with more transparent prices for compute availability and fewer hidden fees. No more unexpected thousands of dollars of debt you didn't want. As computing would not have a central provider, developers would be able to deploy cloud-independent applications, decreasing training and maintenance fees. Another very important benefit of having a decentralized computing system built on blockchain is the inherent security benefits that the blockchain provides. This would make future applications more hack-proof and lower the barrier to creating safe applications. The benefits of having a decentralized computer do not stop here. Just like Bitcoin had its Bitcoin miners that managed to create big companies just mining Bitcoin, so too will there be an opportunity to provide computing resources for the decentralized computing system. Anyone would be able to monetize the computing devices they have at home and contribute to society. Inevitably, this will start the race to the bottom, to make the infrastructure for computing even cheaper and faster than today, increasing the humanity's progress towards a faster and cheaper processing. Currently, what stops this being the reality is mostly the problems with scaling and speed that the current blockchain networks have, as well as lack of awareness and adoption. There are several startups that are working on solutions, with some actually getting really close, such as iExec. The future may be closer than you think. How soon do you think will the dream of decentralized computing come true? Write down what you think in the comment section below. Like and subscribe for more content like this.